guys, Delamook here with another gaming video, where today we're back in Day Shift to Freddy's 3, this time with the full game. So, I had to play through the entire game again to get back here, but I did it. Some things are different, some aren't. The only real difference I can remember is that I added a desk thing to our security office. I made a bit more money on the day where we were scrounging for money. But anyways, back on the flip side, doors open, let's-a-go! And here we are, back in the flip side. Come on, Dave. Oh, no. We gotta fight first. What the? Where'd the balloon boys come from? I don't know, kill them all. Whoa. Just, wow. Oh, also! In my rush to get through this, I kind of skipped over naming yourself. So, no winner, I guess. I apologize. I don't know what to do. Anyways, if there's any new objects, I'll have Dave talk about them. Also, I think these are new. I can't tell. I don't recognize the toy Bonnies.
I'm Hank, this one, and the story.
Oh. Okay. We got to fight the toy, Freddy! Fight, fight, fight! Anyways. So overall, I'm glad to see this game in full game, because now I don't have to stop right in the middle of it due to a demo. But the only way to get it is still the trilogy, so same link in the description. Anyways, it hasn't really been around too much yet, but there is swearing, profanity, that kind of stuff in this game, so keep that in mind. Anyways, we're heading over to the prize corner. Should be a spirit here.
Well,
it's where Matt worked.
Sportsy.
Yep.
The prize corner. Look at that counter in all of its horrifying hauntedness.
It doesn't look all that haunted to me, Dave.
Give it a second. Maybe something'll pop into existence if we sit in silence for 3 or so seconds.
So just like last time. Okay.
Well, there we have it. Old sport. Something.
Hey, puppet. Jack? Who's that? Is that really you? Yeah, it's me. I go by nothing now. I'm Deadly Emerald, please! Believe me! Believe the player! It has been a while, I guess. Puppet, I haven't seen you since Day Shift to Freddy's 2. D? Why? What are you still doing here? Why are we calling you D? I thought you would have passed by now. True. Well, if I passed, who would have stayed behind to mop up the rest of the lost souls that remained here? Not that really remain here, aside from spectral robots. This place has been deathly empty. I understand. It's good to see you again.
Wait, hold on a second. Sportsy, why are you calling that thing D?
My question exactly,
Dave. Is there that a human name for girls? Why on earth are you calling it that?
Dave, this is D. She's... Uh-oh. Hold on a second. I know that voice. Is that Dave Miller? The Kitty Strangler?
In a flash. Or whatever the scaly hide covering my body is made out of.
Oh no. No, 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 no! Oh no, here we go. He's my friend, D. He's here to help. Dave Miller, here to help? My God, you haven't changed at all. Were you bajillion victims that you took not enough? I'm no an idiot, Jack. Every time you two become friends, a trail of bodies appears behind both of you. My God, I can't let this happen.
D, relax. I've learned my lesson in junk.
I was hoping that you'd come back to find me, Jack. Now, I sincerely hope that you haven't. You're going to fill this place with soul after soul. So no child is left alive is going to be able to sleep, thinking of the orange and purple boogeymen lingering outside their bedroom window. I'm going to do what I should have 50 years ago. D, I don't want to hurt you. Neither do I, but I think we have to. But if you get physical, we will have to defend ourselves. Well then, on guard, Jack. All right, Dave. Defend yourself, but don't seriously hurt her, okay?
I'm aiming for this thing, so I'm fucking noodles.
Oh no. Oh gosh. Fight, because they had to defend ourselves, apparently. Really wish there was a life bar. I don't want to accidentally kill D. D. Just calm down, we don't want to hurt you. I know you both too well. The moment I let my guard down, you'll cut my limbs off and throw my head and torso into a trash compactor. No. I'm ending this right now, for everyone.
I'm going to fill that plastic fucking mask of you with how
what? Wants to kill you. B. That's not good. If I die, it's all over. So we're gonna do a double attack. You know I can't keep this up forever, D. I'm gonna tear your insides out, you pathetic orange piece of bare refuse.
Hey, don't talk about my orange baby that way.
What? Dave, stop saying such things. Guard. Guard. Seriously, don't die, please. Oh, no. It's over. My only hope is that these attacks end it. Is there any healing? Buffs Dave's defense, I promise. Buffs Jack's stats for 10 turns can only be used once. Thank you. Buffing Dave's defense might be helpful. You got anything to help me? Work on bosses. Please attack Dave. Oh, you're kidding me. Are you kidding me? I could have. I thought that would end the fight. Uh oh.
Fuck. I'll give it to you, puppet face.
Oh no.
You sure don't go
Wait.
Down easy.
It's not over! Yes! I didn't go down easy the first time, either.
Wait, should I have known that?
Yes! I was one of the first victims that you and Henry abducted. Number 3.
Wait, hang on a second. You're the girl. The one Henry took away from.
Oh, so you do remember. Well, I can remember quite a bit too, William. Do you remember that sadistic F did to me, William? To call my death clean, to be called Fredbear Big Bone. Oof. No. No.
I was never okay with what Henry did, I swear. I tried to talk him out of it.
I'm no different than any of the children you murdered in your own violation, William. You're evil. No two ways about it. And now, you've corrupted my own flesh and blood.
Sportsy, how did you know what that thing's name was?
Dave. She was my sister.
Oh, no. I had no...
Oh, so now you feel remorse. Now that you know who I am.
What?
I was only one of many casualties. The other kids all had families too, Dave.
What? Henry told me.
You snuffed out so many childhood, Dave. Surely you knew what you were doing. What you were taking away from your victims.
I was doing you a favor.
A favor?! To play every future birthday party I could have had. Every Christmas morning. Every walk in the park with my family. I never got to grow up, get married, have children of my own. My future died because of you. Don't you remember your own childhood? Didn't you have any idea of what you were taking away from us?
I do remember my own childhood, if you could call it that.
Oh, I get it. How pitiable. The killer has a tragic past, so I, a victim of this shitty actions, have to pay for it. Well, no, I'm sorry. That don't cut it, William. You weren't the only one here with a far from idyllic childhood. Jack, me, and our brother Peter were orphaned. Who's Peter? I wanna know.
I'm sorry to hear that. I take it Jack is Sportsy's true name, then.
Yes, it is. Yeah, but honestly, Deadly's fine too. Our parents died in a car crash, I'll have you know, leaving Jack and Peter working full-time to support me.
Hey, don't worry, sis.
Don't ever call me that.
I know how you feel. I never had any parents either.
Wait, you must have had somebody if you survived to adulthood.
Well, from a young age, I was cast out of an orphanage. Turns out nobody really wants to adopt an orbishing kid.
Aye.
New York City in the 1950s. Good luck if you were homeless. You'd be lucky to get a nickel most days. People find goodwill and charity tedious after so long of hearing about the needy children.
Oh, so, no.
I learned how to play the trombone, performed for bread, drank rainwater, slept wherever it wasn't wet. I survived, didn't I?
I don't understand this to such hardship, and yet... Where did you go? What happened next?
Well, I ran away from home. Went rogue. Traveled for a while through upstate New York. Drank rainwater in Utica. Steam dams in Albany. Then, near the border, I saw something different. Something wondrous.
What was it?
Dr. Miller's Fantastical Circus. Where fantasy is made real, and life has meaning. A local traveling circus, starting by on its way to Vegas. I snuck in, not having a ticket, and my god, quite the place, allow me tell you. Hot dogs, clowns, lions, excitement. And in the center of it all, stood the ringmaster. A stout fella, pink complexion, in a pinstripe outfit, with his signature hat and bow tie. He was Dr. Henry Miller. I was standing in his circus. He thanked everyone for coming down, and welcomed us to his show. Promised a show to serve shattering illusions. Guaranteed to prove that the impossible was possible, or your money back. Granted, I snuck in, but I was intrigued by the claim nonetheless. And boy, did he make the impossible possible. Cannons fired on instinct, as if they were sentient. Trapezoids levitated from bar to bar. Every damn act shattered at least one thing that I thought I knew about reality. The circus itself traveled west, and then south, hitting several stops in the Midwest. I followed the circus around, getting a good view of the show most nights. And every single show was incredible. Henry even had a clown persona that he'd done occasionally. Got on really well with kids. That guy knew how to act.
My God, Henry had a circus, and he was Dave. What happened to the circus?
Well, it never quite reached Vegas. Unfortunately, people tended to turn up missing in towns the circus reached. Bad luck, I guess. The police called it off and arrested the lion tamer, since the disappearances were investigated as murders.
Dave? Henry is not a good man. Please stop.
I heard that guy got put to death. Serves him right. Ruining Henry's circus. Filthy drunk.
It was Henry. Dave, don't take this the wrong way, but I doubt the lion tamer was the culprit.
Oh, trust me. Henry testified in court. Saw him do it. Henry was a good man and a big dreamer. Even after that, he never quite let go of his dream of bringing fantasy to life. He decided to put his doctorate in robotics to use and started up his own restaurant, Fred Bear's Family Diner. All he needed was a hand to help perform on stage, manage customers, invest a little money into his dream. I was a young man at this point and had saved a little bit of money up so I could I just knew it. Henry's dream would change my life forever. I gave him all of the money I had, and told him that I always needed a lend a hand. He cared about me, D. Gave me my own character. Let me help him write jokes for his shows. He gave me meaning. He was the first person that taught me how to dream.
Dave.
What? It's okay. I know Henry did bad things. He meant well, and wanted to be a good person. Me and Sportsy want to right Henry's wrongs, and fix everything. We can still have a happy ending.
Jack? Is that true? Yes, Dee. Aside from the blatant Henry plays, I mean. Dave means well. This isn't the same Dave that we knew on Earth. He's still there. The flip side is a dangerous place, sis. Dave knows this place well, and he could hold his own in a fight. He's useful.
See, I'm useful.
Jack, do you really want to help save everyone that you can? Yes. Nope, not lying. I really do. Well then, perhaps you should return to Earth. Do whatever you need to do. Dave and I can strategize here. I know there's another lost soul nearby that we could help. I just need to figure out how to reach them. That sounds good, sis. Oh, and before I go, Dave, I have something to tell you.
What is it, old sport?
I found you. Or, you found me, I guess.
What do you mean, Sportsy?
Your feral side. Your physical body found me again. It's inside of a rotting spring Bonnie suit. It goes by Dave Trap now.
My God, that's incredibly concerning.
Indeed. But we have nothing to worry about, right? You've learned your lesson about killing kids. Dave Trap can help us.
D, that ain't me.
That's
the side. Part of my soul that can't let go. Couldn't even let go of my own dead body. Sportsy, I'm gonna keep an eye out for what my reality incarnate is up to. Keep your guard up.
Good lord. The last thing we need is another soul to free. Keep a close eye on things, Jack. I will. Thank you, both of you. I'll be back in a month's time. Goodbye, Dave. Goodbye, sis. Farewell, Jack. I know we'll see each other again soon.
Why, Sportsy, don't leave me alone with her for more than a month, or she'll start getting ideas.
What?
Violent, depraved ideas. Oh.
That's somehow worse than I was thinking. I was thinking more like... basically trapping you alone. But that's much worse. Coming from the kitty strangler? That's rich.
Oh, please. If I had 1 foot long noodle limbs, I'd do some.
Goodbye, bro. Be back soon. And with that, puppet fight completed. And yes, I would like to save the game. Woo! Ah, yay, another tape. These things are always good.
Hello, welcome back to the Start Your Own Freddy Fazbender's Pizza Kit 1993 edition. Let's cut the shit. Sport. I know you're listening to this. Who on earth would buy a franchising kit from a company that killed dozens of innocent children? Aside from you. We are a family, old sport. You were lost, but you soon will be found.
What?
I'm going to come find you, old sport. I'm going to come find you.
What? What? Huh? Why? Another day, another dollar. Phone guy has been upgraded for today onwards, using the employee management option when speaking to him in the office in the Tycoon. All employee management options, including hiring, firing, and upgrading phonehead personnel, are available from the office here in the Tycoon. And so here we are, back in the restaurant. To the office. Also, this bathroom's dark now. And there were still pelicans in the disabled one. This is the thing I mentioned. This is new. I bought it because it seemed important. What do you need? Let's check here. Okay, let's check here. I want to make sure there's nothing new I can do. Like, fix the light in the bathroom! Shut layout. That's your order for the building. It's my vending machine. That's true, we could overprice. Woo! How dare you cover the Fredbear poster, though. Woo-hoo! And there's Chica. What do I need? Restaurant layout, restaurant... We need tables. That we do. Yeah, we have enough. That's good. What's the restaurant? Nice. Okay. I have the feeling negative 20 is bad. Just want to make the dining area a bit. Oh. That's what you mean. Nope, too expensive. Not really worth it. Anything else? Stages. Okay, $100 stage. That works. We need one. What do I need? Anything else? No, let's just look at the mascot. Sure, okay. A crap mascot is Fredbear. Oh, we can change it. Ay, ay, ay. Nope. I don't want to change it. Okay, outside I go. Bye. Ah, yes, the typical 1 month later, except... I'm gonna leave it here, guys. Thank you for watching the Deadly Emerald. If you enjoyed this episode of Day Shift to Freddy's, don't forget to like, subscribe, ring the little button, turn off for next week's video. I'll see you in the next one. Look at our restaurant. Just why me? Why? Bye!